والله يدعو إلى دار السلام ويهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم.
بسم الله، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him and we seek His help, His guidance, and His forgiveness. We believe in Him and we trust Him. We seek refuge in Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah and don't die unless you are Muslims. After this, I greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. Welcome back to classical reading and continuation, inshallah, with the book Riyad al-Salihin, Garden of the Righteousness by Imam al-Nawawi, rahmatullahi alayhi. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower his soul with his mercy. Today we talking about chapter 6, and you see it in your book in volume number 1. And it talks about one of the main characteristics again of the Muslim, khuluq al-taqwa, bab al-taqwa. This is something that we hear it always in the introductory page, or whenever we have a class, whenever we have a khutbah, we always hear the word taqwa is repeated. Wherever you read in the Quran, Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you find the issue of taqwa always been emphasized. Before we try to get to some of these verses, we like to make you aware what is taqwa. Taqwa is translated as the fear of Allah. Fear of Allah. Fear of Allah, which bring about a conscience in your mind that you stay away from what Allah forbid. Taqwa also from the word wiqaya, protection, having a shield. That means to make between you and Allah's punishment a shield that this punishment doesn't reach you. Same thing, like as example, if it's raining outside, you carry umbrella, you can call this is taqwa or this is wiqaya. Why? Because it protects you, shield you from the rain. So the taqwa is a behavior in the Muslim life that when he do it, it will shield him from Allah's punishment. This is what his taqwa is. The taqwa been explained by many scholars and many of the Salaf al-Salih. They talk about the taqwa. And one of the main definition which reported by Imam Ali, may Allah be pleased with him, radiallahu anhu, is saying what the meaning is. At-taqwa هي الخوف من الجليل والعمل بالتنزيل والرضا بالقليل والاستعداد ليوم الرحيل. Definition of taqwa, that act according the revelation. العمل بالتنزيل. Be content with the little bit that Allah had gave you. الرضا بالقليل. Preparation for the hereafter. استعداد ليوم الرحيل. So the taqwa is have a linguistic meaning and religious meaning, and it has a beautiful a sense that to be in our daily life as Muslims. a person to act according what Allah do and don't. Whatever Allah do it, you do it. And whatever Allah forbid, you stay away from it. This is part of the taqwa. And you, for you to be content. Because if you are not content with whatever Allah give you, you're going to try to reach out and you try to grab other things which may be a shubha, doubtful, or maybe even haram. Why? Because you are not content with whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And preparation for the hereafter, this is something very important, comes as a result of taqwa. You know that the dunya is a temporary station. We are not going to be here forever. So now you are not trying to make the dunya to beguile you. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam always talked to his community about taqwa. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu taqullaha haqqa tuqati. Oh, you believe, fear Allah the true way and in the best manner, that as what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is supposed to be feared. You may have heard me before in a program that we're talking about driving, speeding on the highway, and as soon you see the policeman, you slow down, you hit the brake. We need to take, is this like a small picture? The fear of seeing something or knowing something, you're going to get a violation, you're getting a ticket. So this is slow you down. So the taqwa of Allah, knowing Allah, and as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ. They did not estimate Allah in the proper estimation. Because if we really know who is Allah, and the power of Allah, and the might of Allah, and the punishment of Allah, we're going to be so scared. And this fear that comes in our heart is going to prevent us from doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid, which is something good. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he himself used to call in Allah, ask Allah to give him the taqwa. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam remind his community every time he's giving them khutbah, every time he performing a nikah or wedding, he always reads these three verses: Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu taqullaha haqqa tuqati wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu taqullaha wa qulu qawlan sadida. The Prophet always repeating these three verses. Why? Because the taqwa is something very important. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the taqwa to be a goal to be rich by fasting. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So this is the goal to reach taqwa. Oh, you believe fasting been prescribed for you, has been prescribed for those who before you, that you may learn taqwa. So the whole thing is to have the taqwa of Allah. Because if you really get the fear of Allah, this will slow you down, at least if it's not going to prevent you of doing the haram. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ. Fear Allah to the best of your ability, according your means, whatever you can do, as much as you can. The fear of Allah here, that means fulfill the obligation to the best of your means which is available. This ittaqullaha mastata'tum. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows how far you can go, how much you can be patient, how much you can stay away. So if you try your best and after this you could not go beyond this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows your capacity and He knows your limits. But taqwa, my dear respected brothers and sisters, is something very important. And we need it because we face a lot of trouble and hardship in this life. But with the khuluq and the mannerism of taqwa, fear of Allah, conscious of Almighty Allah, avoiding the haram and doing what Allah commanded us to do, Allah is saying, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. Whosoever fear Allah, whosoever going to practice taqwa, Allah will make an exit for him. You can imagine yourself in a room that no place for you to escape and there is a fire there. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open an exit for you when this fire comes. Why? Because before you was acting on taqwa, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. He will make a way out for him. And what else? Pay attention. وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لا يحتسب. And Allah will provide for him from means and ways he has no expectation. We always know, yes, in the end of 2 weeks, I'm getting a check, $900. And I understand another 2 weeks, I'm getting another checks for $200. These things that you count on it. But there is other means and other ways Allah can provide for you that you don't even count, you don't even think about it. But this is not going to happen to you while you are in the ma'asiyah, in the disobedience of Allah. You have to fear Allah. Allah will make a way for you. Allah will make a way for you. And the rizq does not have to be only money. Does not always have to be money. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you health, this is not a rizq. What about if you're making $1 million and you're losing your eyes, your vision? What are you going to do with the money? They spend all this $1 million and after this you could not get your eyes back. So Allah said, وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. Allah will provide for him. Who? The one who or he or she who had practiced taqwa will make an exit for him out of problems and difficulty and hardship. And Allah will provide for him from a place he has no expectation. So we need to understand about the importance of this and the taqwa that is stay from things which, especially evil things and things which is doubtful things. Listen to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which reported by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, may Allah be pleased with him. There's a Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, "Inna dunya hulwatun khadira." وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى مُسْتَخْلِفَكُمْ فِيهَا فَيَنْظُرَ كَيْفَ تَعْمَلُونَ. Indeed, life, dunya, hayat al-dunya. I'm sure you know what's hayat al-dunya. Everybody uses the term dunya, dunya, okay? So this hayat al-dunya, the Prophet ﷺ said, green and pleasant. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had put you in this dunya, so he can see how you're going to conduct yourself. It's a test. Being in this life, dealing with this life, is a test. تبارك الذي بيده الملك وعلى كل شيء قدير الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم. Is the issue of being tested in this life, is something already been recorded in the Quran? You have to know you're going to be tested. You're going to be tested by many things. By desires, by lust, by hardship, difficulty, by everything. But listen what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying. Yes, dunya is good, attractive, beautiful. You see different things. But say Allah had put you, place you in the dunya to see how you're going to do, how you're going to behave, how you're going to act. When you see the green light, what you're going to do? And when you see the red light, what you're going to do? What is the advice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Very important. فاتقوا الدنيا واتقوا النساء. فاتقوا الدنيا واتقوا النساء. Stay away from the dunya. Utilize only for what is needed. You know, don't get, you understand, get deeper and deeper in the dunya. You're going down in the ocean, you're going drown. You don't know how deep dunya is. It took many people before you, bigger than you, wiser than you. When you are not careful, when you don't have the taqwa of Allah, when you don't have the fear of Allah, you're going to be sinking in the dunya like a person going down and down in the ocean. He's going to die there. This is the end of it. So stay away from the dunya. Utilize the dunya. Make the dunya in your hand, not in your heart. Okay? Islam doesn't forbid you to use the dunya. Use it to get closer to Allah. This was the dunya for. All right? To bring you closer to Allah. Utilize it to be a means to take you to the akhirah. This is a, okay? And the second warning, okay, for me and you. The second warning, وَاتَّقُوا النِّسَاءِ. And be aware of women. فَإِنَّ أَوَلْ فِتْنَةِ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ كَانَتْ فِي النِّسَاءِ. The first trial and temptation of the children of Israel was what? In women. And wait. They're going to increase more in number, and the fashion more every day, flooding the market with nakedness and exposing themselves, They're going crazy. They don't know what else to do with themselves. All right? So it's more temptation. But the Prophet said, be careful. Because this is the first fitna happened to the children of Israel. So you need to save yourself. You need to have a taqwa. You need to have a protection from the destruction of the hearts and the destruction of the deen and losing the dunya and the deen. Have what? Have the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So taqwa also to stay away, to avoid something. Okay? Avoid it. Try to make sure that you stay away from women, not mingling, not being sitting on the stand with them face to face, no lowering gaze, and shake hands, and all kind of things. Is a fitna, is a temptation. You are poor, weak, a human being. You don't know what can happen to you. So you don't think you understand you are a superman. We don't have a superman here, okay? This is a fake stuff. You hear it in the TV. There is no superman. You are a human being that can be tempted and be aware because the Prophet ﷺ, bil mu'minin ra'uf rahim, he's concerned about the believers. As a result of this, he warning them to avoid women, avoid dunya, temptation. So the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to stay away from this fitna. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he himself used to call in Allah asking him taqwa, fear of Allah, God conscious. He used to say, Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda wa-tuqa wal-afafa wal-ghina. رواه مسلم. Reported in the collection of Imam Muslim, rahmatullah alayhi, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to supplicate and say, oh Allah, I ask you guidance, I ask you fear of you, ask you make me rich. Does not have to be in money, okay? But you be rich, that you feel satisfied, content in your heart. You can have little, but you feel that you don't need anything else more. And we can see that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he even die, he die and his whipping been there with a Yahudi because he put it as a cradle there for him, you understand, until he can return the loan back. Although he asked Allah, ghina. So, al-ghina, ghina nafs. To be rich, rich inside. Not rich, understand, in your bucket, okay? Because doesn't matter how much your bucket full, you will need more and more and more. So this one of the main things that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to call in Allah, asking him that he give him taqwa. The taqwa is something very important. The taqwa have to be practiced in our action. The taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even in the ibadah. Because some people, they get indulged in so much fitna, temptation. Going in Shiaism, going in Sufism, going in Ahmadism, going in all kind of ism, okay? They don't have a pure Islam. So fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you looking for the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You need to make sure that you are in guidance. Not to understand, I'm worshiping Allah, and this it. Okay, I see the people doing something, and I'm doing it. We have to understand that we worship in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in true guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had told us also in the hadith that whosoever swear and make an oath on something, and later on finds that there is something else better, atqa lillah, falyukaffir anha. That I said, I swear to Allah or by Allah, I'm not going to go to this mosque anymore. For reasons that I'm angry or whatever the reason, that now there is other things supposed to be done, something better. That I see now there is classes started there in the mosque. So now what I'm going to do? What I'm going to do about the oath that I made? I swear I'm not going to the mosque anymore. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, go to the other one. Why? Because the other one, atqa, is better than what you're going to miss. Make expiation for the first oath by fasting 3 days, and this will be expiation, and this will be forgiveness for the oath that he made, and go and do something different, which you go to the same mosque and get the classes and the teaching, which is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had told us about it. Now we see that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in khutbat al-wada', when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the farewell Hajj, and he addressed the Muslim community, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gives him instruction, and the first thing that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells him what? Ittaqullah, fear Allah. And fear Allah, sallu khamsakum, pray your 5-time prayers, sumu shahrakum, preserve the fasting of the month of Ramadan, give the zakah of your property, obey those who are in charge of your affairs. This is part of the taqwa also. And this is destruction of many Muslims, that they are not fearing Allah on their Muslim leaders and those who are in charge of their affairs. We're making revolutions and Muslims getting killed for no reason and all these things. This is not the taqwa of Allah. We need to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And after this, he says that you will enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Taqwa of Allah also in dealing with women. We have to fear Allah. Fear Allah when we're dealing with our women, because they are under our command. They are under our charge. We are supervisor over them. So we have to remember the mighty of Allah and the power of Allah over us. So we fear Allah in the women. Feed them, treat them kindly, not beating them. And if something happens, that we take the proper course of correcting their crookedness. Because this is part of the taqwa of Allah. Because this is like your kingdom there. This is your authority there in the house. It's nobody else over you. So now your fear of Allah will make you remember the power of Allah over you, and you will treat your wife in the best manner. We hear many, many stories about how some husbands, they dealt with their wives. And this is, if it shows anything, it shows that the fear of Allah in their heart is not enough. That the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their heart is not enough. Some people went to the hospital. Some women went to the emergency room. Some women that we see them with a broken arm. This is not what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been described. Used to kana fi mihnati ahli sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He used to assist his wives. He used to be kind to his wives. Even they plotted against him, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so patient with them. So we need to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our wives. We need to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the orphan, because they don't have a guardian over their property. So we did not devout their wealth. All these things part of the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our salah, how we perform our salah. We have to understand that when you enter salah, this is amana, this is a trust between you and Allah, how you perform it. All these things is part of the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And again, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in the Quran, ittaqullaha mastata'tum, fear Allah to the best of your ability. We have to understand that we as a human being, our capacity or our ability are limited. But in the meantime, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ya'lamu kha'inata al-a'yun wa ma tukhfi al-sudur. He knows everything hidden and what's in your heart. So he knows if this is the best he can do or not. You do the best, and inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept it from you. Allah will reward you on it as long as you try to do the best that you can. Ittaqullaha mastata'tum. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Inshallah, before I close, I would like to address my dear respected sisters, and I will tell them also, fear Allah, especially the way when you go out of your houses. You have to understand that we are a human being. We are not angels. We try our best to lower our gazes, our gaze. We try our best to lower our gaze. We try our best to understand, to look to the ground when we're walking. But the fitna became so much everywhere. You don't know where to look. So fear Allah in the way how you go outside. The perfume, leave it for your husband in the house. All this clothes that is showing your fitna and your temptation, leave it for your husband. Fear Allah and know that Allah is a raqib, is a watcher over you. So don't be a cause of taking us away from the Sirat al-Mustaqim. Help us to stay on the Sirat al-Mustaqim by covering yourself properly when you come out of your house. And we say to everybody, fear Allah. We say to the ruler, we say to the teacher, we say to the imam, we say to the father, to the son, to everybody, fear Allah, because this is the best provision, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ تَقْوَى وَاتَّقُونِ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. Take provision. And the best provision is the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Until I see you too next time, inshallah, with continuation of classical reading with Riyadh al-Salihin. Thank you for watching. I'm your host again, Muhammad Said Adli from Columbia, South Carolina. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم and Allah knows best.